How far? Mind you, that's just 20 miles. Jesus, that can't be right. Have I come 20 miles too far? Oh, I have. Okay. I might have a signal now, though. Clearly having too much fun not looking where I'm going. Yes, apparently I've gone way too far, so... Okay, it's not far now then, because that's an old railway station B&B up there. This road was just too good though. So the road's full. Yeah, not a very well marked road. Okay. That'll be why I missed it then. used to be a short stretch. Why do authorities insist on having this sort of road surface? I guess it's quicker to throw down than anything else, but still. Back into England. Not the shortest trip into Scotland ever, but I mean, be far off. I suspect there may be some people doing more than 60 down here. I mean, I know technically I am at this point, but only just. What I mean is like 100. I don't know. Or 80 or something. Thank you. see if we can find anywhere for a cup of tea. A nice cup of tea. There's a cafe. Anyway, the Calimoto is back on. Hooray! Means I know where I'm going, sort of, maybe. Heading back to camp. Honestly, didn't think it'd be held up by bikers. That one's quite a small CC, I guess. Or an older bike, I'm not sure which. But yeah, not making a rash decision on this one. When I was on my Triumph with my brother, and in fact even when I'm on my own, I know if I know there's a faster rider behind, I'll let him by, you know? And what I presume is the she in front of me has looked in a mirror, so she must know I'm here. don't know why you're sitting there. I was having a discussion with someone at base camp at the campsite the other day. He drives a wagon and a lorry, and he was basically saying how crap people are driving these days, and we kind of agree with each other. They're absolutely awful, particularly since the pandemic, but we also agree that the only reason that's the case is because people were awful driving beforehand, and at the moment this just seems to be the way it is. And you know, people are now driving slower to conserve fuel because it's expensive, which in itself isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it's the way they do it. Driving at 40 miles an hour down a country lane, because then they don't have to accelerate to 50 every so often. That sort of thing. Which I guess saves you fuel in accelerating, but you actually have better fuel economy when you do get up to that speed. So who knows? Who knows? As a general rule, I mean, generally it's recognised to be 55 miles an hour, isn't it? Not 88, 55. Nice blue sprint. Let's hope he knows the road. I think slowing to 20 might have been a bit excessive for that sign. Maybe for a car, I guess. What about that? Right, pull over here then. Need to clean my visor, amongst other things. Don't want to go to Barnard Castle. Don't need an eyesight test, just a clean visor. Are removed. Poor cat. This way just because I needed to get somewhere in the end. I actually don't quite like this. take long for Fish Bug to find my visor. See if I can squeeze in here, because there's one reason why I came here. Yeah, I ain't gonna be able to see it, but got people watching me. Shh. Might be a minute. Right, I'm gonna change batteries in a minute, but the reason I want to stop here is because when I was planning routes, I saw a bit of what I thought was road. I thought, oh, there's a bridge there, and actually, to be fair, there is a bit of ford there. But no Google setting would let me do it. At all. And that is why. Not sure I'd want to go over there anyway. So there is just about a ford. But you're not allowed over it. Stepping stones is what they call it. Anyway, not allowed, can't do it. There we go. Be it on Google, I mean, there's not many Google views of this particular thing, so you can't even see the stepping stone. So there I am thinking, oh, there's a path across there, but it won't let me drive. Well, I mean, that's why. But then the only other pictures you get are actually of the stepping stones, which are obviously man-made. So there we go. Right now, I need to change batteries again. Oh, and memory card. So I shall be back shortly. Move on. Everything is on. Thank you. So we're recording again. This time, hopefully, the sound will actually work. Apparently, I've managed to pause it, so I don't know, did I not put it on hold or something and it's pressed pause? I'm going to have to figure out another solution to that somewhere else to put the recorder. Twice in this trip alone that I've managed to stop the recording somehow. Never mind. On the plus side, it was mostly just engine noise and me going "Wee!" all the time. Bother turning that on. You're still on. That's all that matters. No. There is something else that matters. Better. Otherwise, my helmet would come off. Which sounds like a job for a doctor, to be honest. Anyway. Oh, out before the van! Something slow. Oh, a tractor. Have I pissed off a tractor recently? What the hell is that thing? Motorhome with a massive trailer. The speed limit for a motorhome with a trailer? I have no idea. Yeah, they're not hanging about in that motorhome, they're really not. Hello, M6. They're gone off over there, are you? I'll be back in a second. Just taking a detour. think. I was right. I could have been wrong. This road than the M6. May not be as fast, but I prefer it. I'm going to be honest, that's another day of mind-blowing fun. I mean, Kielder itself was a bit of a disappointment, I thought, in terms of the roads, you know. But I guess you'd look at Google Maps for that sort of thing, don't you? But getting up there was oodles of fun. And the majority of coming back has been oodles of fun. Tomorrow, assuming it doesn't get too hot, it's going to be straight home. I say straight home, it's like 2 hours, but straight home. Back roads and whatnot. Fabia, go! And he did. And we're back, well, pretty much. Another successful day of not dying. I think I could have done on a couple of occasions. It doesn't matter, it doesn't matter. I don't know if I'm going to include them in the video or not, so you may not see it. But just be aware that I may have died. But anyway, back at base camp, safe and sound. And that's been another really enjoyable day, I think. Yeah, I'd say Kielder itself, meh. But, yeah, the rest of it is a bundle of joy. A little bit of traffic here and there, you kind of expect that. Fabulous. I'm coming up here again at some point.